And I ain't never seen something so round. How round? Round like a planet in orbit. Round like a b-ball, 23 Jordan. Dunking on default, automatic forces attract me to females. I look this gorgeous. How did you even come in existence? Hey.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, coming to you now from the foot of the Rockies in Denver, Colorado. A moment ago, through a shower of pyrotechnics, it was the hometown Broncos taking the field as they get set to do battle with the Cleveland Browns.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
And off we go from Denver. A nice little gift there to start the ball game as they will begin things at the 40-yard line. Second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. That time, Bradley Chubb shooting in there for the sack.
All right, partner, I'm going to be Captain Obvious right here. Not the start you're looking for offensively, right? Incomplete pass, followed by a sack.
And when he went down, it looked like that right ankle got turned, but thankfully he popped up okay, and they breathed a sigh of relief on that sideline. Mayfield and his Browns offense staring at a third and long now after the sack. Play fake, Mayfield. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And that will be incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
He gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line.
23-yard line.
Lock and the Broncos going to come up first and 10 at their own 23. He'll drop to throw. He's going to drop this one down to Gordon. No gain, and it's second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He can make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. From the gun, it's Locke. And this is going to be incomplete.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. Shotgun snap to Locke. He's got a man. It's Sutton that's complete. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Solid gain of 18 yards and a Denver first down. Looks to throw it again. Got Gordon open, completes it. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So second catch on the drive. He may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, 2 catches. So if they can get him going in the passing game, that should open up his running game too. Looking to throw again on second down. Lock, and that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well, incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now Lock again. Got a man, it's Judy, complete. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First down Broncos as Lock finds Judy. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. Now the first carry here for Phillip Lindsay. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds.
Well, I tell you what, when you get a running back who can move like that in the open field, that's something to take advantage of, and they certainly did there.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Adrian Claiborne, the one who makes the stop. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Throwing on second down, Lock. This will be caught inside the 10. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that would be pinpoint here.
As I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
They'll try and punch it in. Gordon. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Denver.
It's got to be faithful.
A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Broncos have taken the early lead. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you got to see a fist pump on the sideline from the head coach, don't you? Because he's turning to his bench, and he's telling his team, this is how we prepare. Force the punt, go downfield and score. I told you guys, it's just like a boxer in the gym preparing for the fight. Now we get to turn it all loose.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. And a 3-and-out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Mayfield off the play fake. And he's got his man on the crossing route. That's Landry. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A good pickup there, 21 yards. Show a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 41. Field hands it off to Chubb. Chubb will have the first down and much more. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb, 41 yards. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up.
Earlier in the week when they had their scouting report meeting, this was the explosiveness that they talked about trying to contain. They were concerned about it all week, yet he still did it to them. Wonder how that's going to carry over the rest of the game.
So all even at seven now as they kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush. Bring some guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
Yeah, we'll see if they can disrupt it here. First and 10, it's Lindsey refusing to go down. And he takes it down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Denver has a first down on the 15-yard play.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Locked now on first down. They'll find Lindsey here. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
Now that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back, on maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of 5. You're just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chains now.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Block now to throw. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns 28. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. First down. He's throw caught right around the 6. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10. And mark him at the 5.
Let's go!
23 yards on the play.
First and goal.
One man in the backfield is Gordon. He'll get it running right. Take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Melvin Gordon. second touchdown here in this first half. And the Broncos have taken the lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Taken about 7 yards deep. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. From the gun, Mayfield. And he'll find Hall. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
A first carry now for Kareem Hunt, and he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. When halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Dancing to his left. Now he'll pull it down. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
A first down throw for Mayfield. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Well, that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. They go play action. Mayfield. They'll let it go deep for Beckham. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver. And now it's third down.
That sun's going to be a factor all game long. I'm not sure it made a difference on that one, but it's something to think about on all deep throws during this time of year.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. Escaping the pressure right. He finds Beckham complete. And this is going to be another first down as he'll make the tackle at the Broncos' 25-yard line. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Mayfield on play action. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over it, and they got there to break that one up.
They go with Chubb on second down. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. The 8th play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. A run for Nick Chubb.
And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. A pickup of 5 that time and a first down. Play action now. Here's Mayfield. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Kareem Jackson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting 3. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of 4. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. Locke going to hand it off here to Gordon. And he'll just keep 2 hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. It'll be a gain of 4 here, and it will take us to the end of the first half of play. That's it for the first half. 2 more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A 1-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Is out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. Ball on the 30, they'll come up with a 2nd and 5. Locke working out of the gun. And his throw is incomplete. Cortland Sutton was the man he was looking for. And it's 3rd and 5.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
And a stoppage here, a timeout before this 3rd down play takes place. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn 1 here in this 3rd quarter. They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. Operating from the gun, Locke. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides. And there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
Here's Sam Martin now as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. He'll send this one into the mile high air, and it's a good one. Landry now on the return. The danger of a punt that good, a 16-yard return. And the Browns will take over 1st and 10. The Browns drive about to get started. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got 3 on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah. Will they make up for it? Working with a 2nd and 4.
Here's Chubb. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, yeah, they'll spot it right in midfield at the 50. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
They couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one score game, first and 10 here. Mayfield this time gets it off to Chubb. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
Throwing again on second down. Mayfield flushed out right. He's going to take off with it. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
This is 3rd and 1, very likely 4 down territory, even if they don't get it, though. Mayfield. They set up the screen to Chubb. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard pickup on 3rd down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Here's Mayfield. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
3rd quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a 2nd and 10. Play-action fake. They'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. Looking left side, that's caught by Landry. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20.
Give him 14 on that one and a 1st down.
That one is caught by Hunt. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. A 14-yard pickup. That's 14 yards on 2 straight plays.
What are you doing?
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal.
At the 8-yard line.
Shotgun, it's Mayfield. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes 3rd and goal. Mayfield down. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. Marvin Hall there to make the grab. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic. But usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed,
They use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There the results in a touchdown.
The Broncos take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. They'll start the drive with a run by Gordon. Tackle made there by Myles Garrett.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. They keep it on the ground again, Gordon. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
A loss of 1 brings up third down and 11.
Welcome back now to Denver. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. Welcome back now to Denver. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. The Broncos on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 11. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. The Broncos on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 11. Shotgun snap to Lock. And the Browns pressure gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. The number one pick, Myles Garrett, coming in to drop him. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
Now Landry. Nice work on the return as he gets about 15 yards back. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Browns drive about to get started. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter. Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 16 more on that one and another first down. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Chubb. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
They'll give it to Chubb. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown, you're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
One in, and he is unable to get in. They stop him at the line of scrimmage. They're held again, and do we have a goal line stand brewing? It's third and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action and throw the ball.
And he's in. Touchdown, Browns. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Browns have moved out in front.
Well, they decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times, that's a passing play.
And the kicker just has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
Good catch made at the 25-yard line. The Broncos take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
36-yard line.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. A run with Lindsey out of the gun. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a third and 2 more.
Short gain, last 2 plays. Who do you think's excited about that?
Absolutely, this defense, they're saying go right ahead with those. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third.
Partner, you've got about 20 coaches on your payroll, but there's 60,000 of them in the stands. I don't think any of them like that play.
And the later we go, it's starting to sound like 100,000 in here. To throw for it on fourth. He's got a man. It's Sutton that's complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. They'll look to throw. Screen pass to Lindsey. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Now the Broncos will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. So they have had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. To throw. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle. Got to totally command it, make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
Locked to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Lindsey. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That's 30 yards now in the last two plays, back-to-back 15-yarders, and they're rolling. The give to Gordon. Now here's Locke to throw. That's going to be caught. And he's across for a touchdown, and it's likely the game winner here in the closing stages.
Obviously, the excitement level here is almost a fever pitch. Down one. It's tempting to go for two. I say you go ahead and kick the extra point. You got the home crowd carried into overtime.
I'm with you. I do see some fans are holding up two fingers. Easy now.
Yeah, but they're not the ones who have to actually make that call, are they?
Look at this. They're not even going to get the two-point play off. Maybe too much indecision. It's going to cost them 5 yards. That's going to set them back 5 yards. So now this will be, in all likelihood, to force overtime. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. So now this will be, in all likelihood, to force overtime. And this place has gone stone silent. Their guys remain down by a point.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Down to one knee goes Mayfield, and that's all she wrote. So Cleveland able to come away with the victory here. And I tell you what, they were big favorites coming in, but they had to work for this one.
It certainly wasn't the walk in the park that you expected coming into this one. I have a suspicion that in their meetings next week, head coach going to talk to him a little bit about focus, don't you think?
Yeah, because down the street.